Morning, guys. Brooke Potter here. I have been challenged to the ALS Ice Bucket Challenge by my good friend Yuan in Sweden. Thanks, bro. And I was also challenged by Sue Beach, but as of yet, from today, she has not actually completed the challenge. She's actually trying to challenge me on credit, but that's not going to fly. But I am going to do the challenge, but before I do that, there are a couple points I want to make. Guys, you would not believe the emails that I'm getting concerning this challenge, and I mean, most of it is ridiculous. One guy says that it, you know, this is a satanic baptism that's going to open up portals to some kind of, you know, toenail biting demon with Tourette's. Another person is saying that, you know, this is a form of torture that was used on slaves and stuff like that. Guys, this is something called the fallacy of the undistributed middle. It basically goes like this: a cat has four legs, an elephant has four legs, therefore a cat is an elephant. Guys, ice water has been used for ages for all different kinds of things. Just because, you know, athletes might, you know, use ice water to help their body heal faster doesn't automatically mean that if I dump myself in ice water, I'm going to become an all-star athlete. And to my friends who are very concerned about this being a demonic and satanic ritual, I will just remind you that in the satanic church, most of the rituals are performed upon an altar, and the altar that is used in these rituals is actually a naked woman. According to the satanic Bible and the rituals, that women are the very natural conduits of which the earth energy can flow through freely. So if you are afraid of ice water and think it's somehow demonic, you should also be afraid of women, seeing as they are the natural conduits to the earth. So if you're going to be consistent and you're going to avoid this challenge because it's a baptism, I hope you're consistent in avoiding women also. And if you happen to be a woman and you believe this kind of stuff, well, sucks to be you. But of course, we don't believe in this stuff. We believe in Jesus Christ, and he is Lord over all, and all of this other nonsense, you know, cannot overcome the power of what he has done for us on the cross. I also got word that, you know, that the ALS Foundation is killing babies, which is kind of interesting because they're actually not in the abortion business. On August 26th, they put out a press release concerning the whole issue of stem cells. And they pointed out that, you know, they use adult stem cells, and there is only one facility that uses embryonic stem cells, and that entire facility is sponsored by one donor. You can go onto their website with the press release dated August 26, 2014. I'll put a link in the description, and you can read all about that. And anybody who's concerned that their money is going towards these things, they very well say that you can stipulate no embryonic stem cells, no destruction of life in their donation. And your money would probably go towards machinery and equipment and these other kinds of things. So guys, don't let that kind of stuff stop you. Also, we have a lot of people who have suffered from this disease. I know of a couple personally. And I'd just like you to know that, you know, we're praying for you. And if you know somebody who wants prayer, you know, you could contact me on my blog or anybody from the Royal Family International or any of the number of us who are involved in the healing ministry. And we will continue to pray for you and stand for you for all to be well. You know, the ALS Foundation has been rated as one of the top charities by these independent research groups. So your money is going towards a good cause. It's, I think it was rated one of the highest in transparency and accountability. So, you know, at least nobody's going to be running off with your money and that kind of thing. On my last point, you know, dumping a bucket of ice water upon me is not really a challenge here on the island. That's basically how we do air conditioning here. So I'm going to be doing things a little differently. So, you know, I hope you enjoy. For those of you who want to find out more about the information I've discussed, you can go to the ALS website at alsa.org. I will put the link in this video and in the description, as well as links to all of the press releases, so you can check this thing out. Guys, let's not make an excuse not to support this charity. We have a lot of people who are really suffering out there, and those of you who think that this challenge is demonic, I could tell you up front that this sickness is demonic and we must do everything in our power to stop it. So guys, the moment of reckoning. I will be nominating four people for this challenge. Starting with my good friend Dexter Forgenet. You're up, bro. Terence Hosang. Sorry, bro. Just had to be done. Charisse Baliram. You know who you are. And Wendy Ramdeen, because you've come up with every excuse not to do this challenge, and that which you have feared has finally come upon you. So guys, with that said, let's do this. We'll be right back.
this is what's going to happen. As you see, I'm in this bathroom right here. Not only am I going to dunk myself with the ice water, but as you've seen, I have filled this tub here with water, and I'm going to include these 7 bags of ice in it to make an ice bath. And after I've dunked myself, I'm going to lay down in this ice water, and that should pretty much cover me for anybody else who might decide to challenge me for this. I would consider the challenge done. And for all the greenies out there who say I'm wasting water, as you see, I'm going to be using this ice to cool my rum and my Coke so I can enjoy a very nice beverage, so I'm not wasting the water. Okay guys, let's do this. So this is the bucket of ice water, this is the tub, I'm going to get into it, and we're going to get this thing done.
Okay, driver, you know, so...
What?
Go on.
Yeah. All right.
Let's go.
Whew. I can't feel my toes. All right. That's part one. Oh, shrinkage. I'm going to feel that in the morning. Thank you. Okay, guys. 24 hours. You guys got to do this.
Whew. So there you have it, guys. ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. You guys have 24 hours. Here's my rum and Coke. So let's get to it, guys. Take care. Excellent. All right.